Welcome to the 16th lecture of Economics and Management. In today's lecture, we will talk about double entry bookkeeping. So these are the points that we are going to cover in this lecture. We will talk about various terminologies. We will talk about amount, debit, credit, what is journal and what is ledger. So these are few definitions. First is entity. It is a specific area of accountability. A clear-cut boundary for reporting. For example, firm. Let's say firm is one entity of which we are going to keep an account. Next is transaction. Any event that changes the financial position of an entity. Let's say the entity is firm and we are keeping account of that firm in some bank. Then if we made any transaction, then financial position of that entity changes. If we take some money from the account of firm, the amount will get reduced, and if we add some money into the account of firm, the amount will get increased. So the financial position changes of that entity. That is known as a transaction. Bookkeeping is known as a recording of a business transaction. So whatever transaction we are going to do, that is known as a bookkeeping. Now in this case, we are going to make two entries for every transaction. So from where the money is added and from where the money is reduced. So these are two entries we are going to keep. When we add some money, we are going to add from some account, and that will get added into some account. So we are going to keep two entries for every transaction. That's why the name of topic is double entry bookkeeping. Now what is meaning of entry? Record in the book of accounts in respect of transaction. So there is a book of accounts in which we are going to keep record of every transaction. So that is known as an entry. And double entry that I have explained. We are going to keep two entries for every transaction. So it is known as double entry bookkeeping. Now for every transaction, the following exists. First is there is a receiver and there is a giver. Receiver or debtor whose amount increases. Okay, the one who is receiving is known as a debtor and whose amount increases, and giver who is a creditor whose amount decreases. So let's take one example. There is a transaction. Cash is paid to buy two chairs. Now there is a chairs account in which money will get added. The total amount invested in chairs increases, right? As we are going to buy chairs, so total amount invested in chairs increases. The amount is debited to chairs account. The amount is debited to chairs account. So chairs account is a receiver or a debitor whose amount increases. Cash is given, decreasing the cash position of the entity. So cash is given by the buyer, so cash position of that buyer decreases, and the amount is credited to cash account. Now creditor whose amount decreases, so the cash will get reduced from the creditor's account. The amount is credited to cash account. Now debitor is in a language of account, it is written as DR, capital DR dot. And creditor is written as capital CR dot. Now this is a form of an account. So if you see, there are two dates, two particulars and two amounts. So in this way, we are keeping two entries. Left hand side shows the debit and right hand shows the credit. Then there are, so date shows the date on which the transaction is made. Particulars shows the information about the account, and amount, the amount credited or the amount debited. Then there are few types of accounts. Personal account, in which personal and impersonal. So in personal account, there are debtors, creditors, capital account of the owner. And impersonal, real accounts in which asset of the firm, for example, land, building, cash, etc. And second is nominal account. For example, expenses, losses, gains and revenues. So in all personal accounts and real accounts of impersonal at the end shows the same balance. So it shows the same amount, but nominal accounts it shows losses and gains. So your money in the account will increase or money in the account will decrease. So these are types of accounts. Next we will talk about debit. So as I have told you, debit is the left hand side of an account. It has a Latin origin and it is written as DR dot, D is capital. So what debit does? A debit increases the value of an asset but decreases the value of a liability. Debit decreases the value of liability. So what is meaning of liability and asset? We will talk it about afterward or in the next lecture. But at this moment, just keep in mind, a debit increases the value of an asset but decreases the value of a liability. Now credit. Credit is written on right hand side of our account. It is again have a Latin origin. It is written as a CR dot. In this case, C is capital. A credit decreases the value of an asset but increases the value of liability. Increases the value of liability. Journal. So journal, the book in which entries are recorded. It is a book in which all transaction entries are recorded. It is also called as book of original entry. So let's say there is a transaction, a material is brought on a payment of rupees 20,000. So date is written, particulars, purchase account to cash account, right? And debited amount is 20,000 rupees and credited amount is 20,000 rupees. Now ledger. The book which contains the account is known as a ledger. So there is a difference between journal and ledger. In journal, there are entries are made, there are transactions are written. Whatever transactions are made into the account are written into the journal. But the ledger contains the accounts, right? And journal contains the transactions of the account. It is a principal book. Contains accounts, it contains personal account and impersonal account. Entries in the journal are posted in the ledger. So whatever entries we are having in the journal, that are posted into the ledger. In short, the journal contains the transaction of the account and ledger contains all types of accounts. So let's say there is a transaction, a raw material is brought on the payment of rupees 20,000. The relevant ledger account, T accounts, as it can be written as T accounts as shown in below. So there will be inventory account and there will be cash account. So inventory account, so cash will be credited 20,000 rupees and so cash will be debited into the inventory account and credited into the cash account, and it will be credited by inventory. And so to cash account 20,000 and by inventory 20,000. So first entry in the journal, the opening balance in an account in the beginning of new year is the closing balance of the account in the previous year. So whenever we are going to make first entry into the journal in the very beginning or first day of the financial year, so that will be the closing balance of the previous year. Closing balance of the previous year. It is written as to balance brought down. So it can be written in the language of accounting as to bal dot b slash d. It is written in the debitor side of an assets and creditor side of for the liabilities. Right, dr dot is a debitor and cr dot is creditor. So let's take one example. Hari open a new hardware shop by investing rupees 1 lakh. In the first month of operation, there were 4 transactions. Hari brought furniture worth rupees 20,000. He brought goods worth rupees 50,000 with rupees 30,000 on credit. And the remaining amount on cash payment, he sold material worth rupees 7,000 for rupees 10,000 cash on payment. She paid back ₹10,000 to the suppliers of the good. So whatever the information given in the previous example is written in this particular chart. So there is an inventory account and the amount paid in the capital. So on debitor side, there are ₹50,000. So credited. So 7,000 are credited. So the remaining on debited side are ₹40,000. So likewise, there is a cash account payable. There is retained earning. There is a furniture account, and expenses and revenues are also given. You go through this chart and read the information carefully so that you will understand how the transactions are taken place. So today we will stop here. Thank you so much.